Just your views personally on how the markets have performed today, losing 88 points.
Hi, Lerato. Yes, the market went down today. I think it's about 0.33% from information reaching me just before I got on this interview. And that's a continuation of the bearish trend we've seen for the last 2-3 weeks or so. So the market not doing very good today.
Okay, let's talk about what we're likely to see just by way of general equity trends. I think volumes and just general activity on the banking front has been a bit subdued and a bit flat on other counters as well.
Yes, you're right. The trends in the market show that the performance of the equity index has been bearish over the last 2 to 3 weeks or so. This may be a reflection of the investors' perception about the Nigerian market and the Nigerian economy in trying to find an explanation for the bearish trend we've seen. Some analysts have opined that foreign portfolio investors, which had played a major role in the market at the beginning of the year, are taking a wait-and-see approach as we head towards the elections.
Right.
There are also issues around the recent list released by the Stock Exchange regarding the capitalization of brokers and the
right.
response that brokers have taken to address that issue. My view is that going forward, leading up to the elections, we're likely to see a continuation of the bearish trend. We
right.
may see some modest gains, but I expect investors to still... I expect profit takers to still
right.
be active in the market and push down any persistent rise in the index and gains.
I mean, obviously, we've got the regulator in studio to discuss these new directives on capital requirements, but just basically by way of industry's response, what's your opinion?
Just to clarify, there is no official statement from the SEC regarding a capital increase or a date for a deadline for increasing capital on the part of market operators. These comments were comments made by the DG of SEC at various fora. I think there were interviews or presentations she made at various fora. And what they have said is that they would like to see a situation where there's an increase in capital and possibly a reduction in the number of brokers. Now, having clarified that, let me say that capital adequacy is an important issue for any business. There's no doubt about that because it defines the amount of risk that a business can take. However, in the general consensus among market operators is that that may not be the priority at this time. It's important to look at other areas. You will recall that based on our recent experience in the banking industry, too much capital with weak regulation, weak risk management, weak professionalism, if I may put it that way, could create further problems. So we think that the SEC should focus more on instilling professionalism, ethics, strengthening its oversight functions, and ensuring that the market confidence returns, because pronouncements that are not explained properly to the markets could have the
right.
undesired effect of affecting investor confidence.
Okay, I'll raise that issue with the interim administrator, who's going to be speaking to me in just a second. Let's talk about the primary market, which seems to be quite quiet. What are some of the news about concerning issues in this particular segment of the market?
Well, in this segment, we do not have many upcoming equity issues. A few corporate institutions have talked about issuing bonds in the first quarter or the first half of this year. And we haven't seen much activity in that respect, but we think that there will be some activity in the bond space. Of course, watching the direction of interest rates is key to that, because it may affect the ability of corporate issuers to raise capital
right.
at attractive prices.
I mean, obviously, the interest rates had significant bearing on the interbank market and raised the rates, which has really led to questions as to whether or not we're going to see a bit of flight from the market. You're talking about the process of corporate issuances. We'd started to see some sort of steady improvement on that front in Nigeria late last year. What's it going to take to sustain that trend, do you think?
Well, I think that the elections are playing a major role in economic activity in Nigeria. I mean, and until the elections are over, I don't see much happening by way of new issues. However, be that as it may, we know that it's still important for companies to raise capital, and you know, they'll be looking at the interest rates, they'll be looking at you know, the yields that they can offer investors, and that's very important.